Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Midnight Rice. We're starting a new series called Stormworks Build and Rescue. It's kind of like Kerbal Space Program, kind of like Space Engineers, but with a little different twist. I just got it off of Steam, and it was on like a super sale deal, and worth every penny. It is pretty awesome. I was looking for something new to play since we finished up Farm Simulator pretty much. And I kind of saw this on a YouTube video and I was like, oh, that looks awesome. Because I like Space Engineers and I like the other one. So I was like, let's try it out. And now we're addicted. So we're going to start a new game and I'll explain what's going on with all this. And I'll kind of give you a heads up on how stuff works with it. So let's start a new game. And here's where you put in your world seed, which is just like Minecraft. We'll throw some numbers in there. There is an easy mode. There's a creative mode. Easy mode, you don't have to worry about running pipes and all the extra parts for your motors and everything like that. Basically, in this game, you build a ship, an airplane, or a helicopter. In the beginning, we're starting out on like the beginner island, so you only can build a ship. You don't have an airport or anything. And the map is just massive, and it's got different biomes. It's got a polar biome, which just came out in a release not too long ago. What else do we got to explain about? Let's get it set up and we'll start playing because I don't want to use up too much time and jabberjawing. We're going to do normal difficulty, which is like a survival. Actually, I think we want survival. We want survival. Survival to the advanced vehicle mechanics, transmissions, pipes, injuries or death, no starting vehicle. Which that's okay. I did some prep work. I made us our own first beginning vehicle because the idea is, you go out and do rescues. Basically, you're building your own Coast Guard from scratch. You go out and do rescues and do missions. You earn cash for those, and you also earn more parts. You only start with a handful of parts. So if you ever played Space Engineers, it kind of works real similar, and you'll see that. But basically, when you first start out, you only start out with a handful of different parts. And as you unlock more, you can make more advanced things on your ships, and eventually you can build helicopters and airplanes, which I haven't been messing around with that yet. We'll get there eventually. So let's get started. So we went to survival mode. I tried it around in creative and stuff to get used to it. And it wasn't too bad. We're advanced vehicles. I'm turning off vehicle damage, player damage, and NPC damage because we're still new. I'll leave sharks on. I guess with sharks, I haven't tried it yet. But there's fish and stuff going around, and it's pretty awesome. But I guess if you spend too much time swimming in the water, the sharks come after you, so it's pretty cool. Permanent death basically deletes your save. So every time you start over, you lose all your progress. So we're definitely not doing that. We're going to do limited fuel because I do want to do that. And we're going to give ourselves... What is that, $1 million? We're going to give ourselves $1 million to start out with. Because every time you build a boat, it costs money. And really, after I built the first boat we're getting ready to use, and I don't know if it costs because I already pre-built it and saved. The nice thing is, even though I started a new game, all my boat designs that are saved are still there. And you can download a crap load of boats if you don't feel like building your own boat, which is kind of the point of the game, so I don't understand that. Or if you just want to test out different features, you go onto the Steam workshop, and there's amazing boats there, everything from aircraft carriers down to little tiny submarines and all kinds of stuff. We're going to start on the starter base because I do want to do it that way. I was going to start us out in the big base so we could do everything, but we're going to start out there. So you can unlock a lot of stuff. We're going to leave all those off, unlock all the components. We want to work for it. So that's pretty much our setup there. And, you know, maybe when we'll restart eventually when we get really good at it and turn all the difficulty stuff on. But for now, I think we're in a good spot here. So we hit confirm, and we'll go through a little loading screen while I sip on soda. Good stuff. And it plays fairly smooth. I mean, I'm always worried because my graphics card's getting a little bit older, but this game it's got amazing physics. It kind of looks like an old, that's the one I built, so I don't feel like making a new one. So we're going to go ahead and hit complete, and then we're going to go to our little house. This is our little house. Really, the only main functioning thing in your house up here is your bed. If we go like this and sleep in our bed, we can actually sleep away. You see this little circle thing right here. This is nighttime. This is daytime. So right now we're about at noon. It gives you the date and all that. So if there's a really bad storm you don't want to deal with, you can just kind of sleep it off. And plus, if you use up your missions, you have to wait a day for new ones to spawn up, and that also does that too. So we want to get out of our bed. We don't want to sleep right now. We just started. I'm not even sure what's going on here. But you got switches and all that stuff. So it's, like I said, it's an amazing game. It's still an early access game, as you can see. But from what I've heard, they just have been adding one amazing thing after another. The developers are awesome. So don't let the graphics fool you. You know, it's kind of got that... It kind of reminds me of Team Fortress or something like that, or like an older you know, game. Don't let the graphics fool you. The physics in this is what it's all about in the building, and that is amazing. So we're going to get down here. Right here. This is our first little starting base. You have this big open area here. I'm assuming you can build helicopters here or something. They gave you this open space. But when you use the workbench, it always spawns everything down in our little boat dock here, so I'm not sure. There's our fuel container there where we take our fuel from. It should tell you how much we have, but yeah. So that's pretty cool. It reminds me, you know, it's like a little bit better than Minecraft as far as the, you know, there's a little more rounded edges and stuff. But we got a big work light here that I'm sure we can switch to turn on. I don't know what that does. Okay. So we got a big floodlight we can turn on. And maybe we just need to unlock that ability is to build out here. But right now all we can do is build boats. And I'll kind of show you what I did and kind of how I did it. Doesn't make it the right way, and I've had more failures than successes, but we do have a working boat. I wanted to get us at least a working boat to start out with because we are playing in an advanced mode. Advanced mode, you have to have... Well, I'll show you. All right, let's get in here. We'll spawn up my boat. So we'll load the boat. It always gives you an autosave. I always get rid of those. So the first thing I do is start out with like a hull, and I save my hull as like a master, so if I want to come back, because I know this one will float. Occasionally I'll have problems with them not wanting to float. So see, it's cute. Ooh, I missed a spot. Sorry, OCD's setting in. All right, there we go. So it's cube-based, and I missed one over here too, damn it. So you build by blocks, and they do have different pieces and parts, and actually let's clear this out so I don't get confused here. So if you played Space Engineers, this will be really comfortable for you because it's pretty much laid out the same way except you're on the sea. So basically all I did was I built our basic hull. And I'm not a great boat builder, but I was pretty happy how that turned out. So we got like a basic ship, and it's not a super huge one. See, we can do this thing. I think we can switch to... So that's what it's going to look like in the dock. So you got to stay within that building square. The only thing I don't like and my big complaint about it is... Even when you go like this and grab them, that's as close to the water as you can get it. So when it spawns, it drops. Well, if you're just testing out, like right now, we're going to test out that hull, which we'll do that by hitting, we'll spawn this. I just want to show you this and we'll get into the actual boat. See, it automatically filled up with water because it dropped it. So it's hard to kind of test stuff out. I wish I could spawn it on land to get it laid out. Because I was trying to get the engines to work, because in advanced mode you have to run fuel lines, do all the other stuff. What I would recommend is doing easy mode to begin with, because all you have to do is put an engine down and run the electricity to like your props. It's a real simplified system. Advanced mode, you have to run coolant lines, you have to run all the stuff, and I'll show you that in the next one. So this is how you test it first. You know, build your little hull, drop it in the water, jump on it a little bit. But it's got amazing physics, because if we sealed this up, water wouldn't be inside. It's not like it's clipping through the boat. It actually, when it dropped, it filled up with water. You can actually eventually, we don't have them to start out with, but you can put in pumps to pump out the water, like bilge pumps. So I've seen some pretty advanced ships on here, some pretty amazing things. And it's just like Space Engineers. I mean, you can build a simple vessel to get you around in space, but then you got people that build, I have a friend at work that builds just these insane, you know, record-breaking ships that, you know, do all kinds of stuff you can't imagine the game can do. So they do give you that opportunity in here, and there's a lot of items to build with. So what I'll show you here... Crap, I forgot to put it away. Anytime you're out here in the dock, you can hit R, and it'll drop you right back to your build block. So this is the area you have to be within with the small base. You can't build it any bigger than this block in here. I'll go over the controls really quick. I just want to kind of get, in case you haven't played this before. So we have select mode. That's when we have components. I'll show you how that works. You have erase, you have paint, you have move, and that's how we moved it around. Like I wanted it closer to the edge here, maybe a little bit farther forward, because that's where the gas pump is. When you do limited fuel on, you have to actually fuel up your ship the first time, and anytime it runs out of fuel. And we'll get into that when we bring up the real boat. But this is what I started with. And I liked it because I know this is float. I know it's a stable craft. So I might build off this platform and just change it a little bit if I want to. We want to build different ideas. Okay, so we got here. We have logic, which we'll get into when we actually spawn the regular boat up here in a second. Merge, I haven't messed around with, nor selection grid. It does have symmetry, which is really nice. Like if we turn this on and we show it, do I have it? I have it on. I guess I don't have it on. My symmetry is not working. Maybe because I have it kicked over to one side. But what symmetry allows you to do, if you run symmetry down the center of your vessel, It mirrors back and forth. Like when I had to build these were a pain in the butt to drag these up here to make these pieces in. It copies it to the other side, so you only have to do one side. It just makes things a lot faster. For some reason, it's not working right now. I have no idea why. Oh, I have it disabled. Okay. No. All right, we'll mess around with it later. It might be just something weird happening. All right, so you have your camera mode. There's two different kinds. There's orbit, which basically what it does is you select the block like we're here. It'll orbit around whatever block you're working on. I didn't like it because it made it really hard to see. Can we close these down? Yeah, let's close those down. I like free mode because it lets you surf all the way around, especially if you seal this off and you need to work on the inside, which I'll show you on our actual boat. It makes it a lot easier to work with. Center of mass will show you where the center. Ooh, I'm a little far forward, but I have a lot of weight in the back too, so that worked out. The center of mass shows you where, just like when you're making, like if you were trying to design an aircraft, you know, finding like the center on it. Arrow directions, I have no idea what that is. I don't know what rotation labels or grid lines is that. You want to see what your boat looks like when you put it out there? Because you don't see the grid lines, I don't think, when it's surfaced. And then you have measurement tool. I'm assuming you can measure stuff with it, and then you can see what it looks like in the actual world, which is kind of nice. Turn your grid lines off. So that's what your finished boat will look like. It's nice and smooth. Sorry, let's hide all that stuff, and let's load up our actual boat. So from that, no, it's nice that it auto-saves because the game hasn't crashed on me yet, but we just took that and we made this. This is our finished product that we get to play around with. Let's take it back inside here and I'll explain some of the stuff. You always want to have seating in your first one. And this is pretty extravagant, I think, for the first boat, but you need this room for all the stuff. So basically what you get, you have these, you can do your hot bars here, but this is what we start out with. Let's choose something here. Let's make them white so they're easier to see. Okay, so you got window blocks. This is like your basic starting gear. You have a regular block, your square block. You have cornered windows. You have handles, which lets you grab onto stuff and move it around, I guess. You have inverse pyramid, which is how I made the front of the boat. You have a ladder, which if your boat's tall like mine, I'd put ladders on it because if you fall off, you can't get back on there. It kind of sucks. More windows, a lot of different windows. The pipes and pieces we'll talk about later. But basically everything's got to be plumbed out when you do it in advanced mode. If you're not in advanced mode, you won't see any of these pipes and pieces because you just don't need them. Really, all you have to do is put this motor down and then put propellers down and then you run cables between the two, which you don't see the cables. I kind of screwed up because it took me for a while. I almost gave up on the game because it's a newer game. There's not a lot of information out there. Any YouTube videos you watch are all people with these massive builds playing multiplayer and stuff like that. So there's still things I'm figuring out. But I thought you had to run an engine into a gearbox, into a clutch, then into the propeller, which is mechanically that's what you have to do. Well, we lost the ability to go backwards. So with this build, can we get right back on it? I'll show you what I did. I'm not really super happy where I ran the exhaust out, but the air has to be above. You know, you can't get water in there because it'll stall the motor out. And so the basic thing you need is to get your hull design, put in some propellers. You need to have a rudder. And we're inside here. This is my electric boat basically built. I'm trying to make it so I don't accidentally put something down. So I got some batteries in here. And I didn't see these at first, so I thought I had to make a mechanical one. But basically what we're doing, if we bring up, this is what your logic mode is. If we go to electrical, I know my wiring is just a disaster. So the basic gist of it is the motor is generating mechanical power or mechanical coming out that shaft in the top. It's going over here. These are all generators, basically. I think I might have went a little insane with it. The generators are charging the batteries. And then everything electrical in the ship is running off of, including our lights up top and lights up front. All your gauges and switches and all that are all running off electricity. So basically you want to charge your batteries. But what I did originally is off this motor. Let me see if I can. Can I switch back to normal? Okay. It's kind of hard to see because that is. Okay, let me turn to a block. That block keeps. It's a really tight space in here. Basically, to see what the engine needs, there's different kinds of engines. This is the only one I've messed around with. Is all you have to do is grab one of these pipes if you decide to go in advanced mode. It's so hard to see. I'm so sorry. But you see all these pipes I got coming off here. Basically, you hold the pipe over one of the holes in the motor, and you'll be able to see what it needs. It'll tell you exhaust, intake, gas, whatever. So the nice thing is even though it's not technically a drive shaft, your power comes out the top of that motor, depending on which way you move it around. You just hook these pipes together, and then they have L-pipes here. So basically, these generators are automatically, it's like magic drive shafts. We got a little bit of a radiator on here. I don't know how that's going to work. I haven't ran the boat for a long time. I wanted to wait for everybody to join us. We got fuel. So I have a couple fuel tanks here, and then I have a fill nozzle coming out the top. And that's where we fill up, because I'll show you how much of a pain in the butt that is. So then you put in controls and dials. And I love to explain. It's so hard to explain it all at once. Get off of that. I hate it when I'm trying to point out stuff, but it keeps throwing a block up. But you'll see these gauges right here. Basically, how I've organized it, and this isn't the best way to do it. It's just I'm still new at it myself, is I think I have – oh, actually, I can do this. All right. So we have our temperature gauge for the engine. We have the RPM gauge for the engine. That's the starter switch for the engine, and then that's the throttle control. But because we're a hybrid, basically we're just using the fuel motor to charge the batteries. So on this side, we have our actual throttle control, and you can also wire stuff through the chair. The chair has, if I bring up the logic, and we bring up data, and it gets confusing, but it's not as bad as it looks. But the chair has got hotkey spots on it. I think it's 1 through 6 or 1 through 8. I think it's 1 through 6. Then all your switches and gauges also have feedback in 2 points on them. So like our switch here, I don't think I have that ran to anything. Oh yeah, maybe I do. I think that's the switch. I think the switch on the outside, and you can label them so it doesn't get confusing. So I would build one switch section at a time. But the nice thing is if you go over the lines like this, it shows where they're going. It's kind of hard with the camera, but then you kind of figure out once you get the spaghetti going here. Yeah, it's pretty insane. Okay, so we got that. I'm just trying to give you a basic rundown of it. So basically how I have it wired up is I can use the W and S keys. For some reason, if you run like a drive shaft motor, I've ran a, you know, like I said, we're running electric motors on those propellers to start out with. And once we get more gear, you'll have different engines to choose from and more options and things to do. So basically what I'm doing is charging the batteries, using the batteries like a submarine to drive the propellers. You can run them direct drive through those gearboxes and clutches, but I don't know, and I can't find the directions on how to make it so you can click into reverse. So basically all I could do is go forward. Well, you need to maneuver. It's a boat. So until we learn how to do that, we're going to stick with the electric motors, and they seem to be working out pretty well. I don't have anything else fancy hooked up to it. We got some lights so we can see at nighttime, because there's day and night, there's storms, there's everything. So let's take it for a test drive, and maybe we'll see if we can do a mission really quick, and I'll explain more. We'll actually see how this works. And it's a lot of testing and building and, trial and error. So let's spawn our new vehicle. Hopefully it'll spawn. See, I don't like how it drops. See, I got a little bit of water in there, but not too bad. This is a pain in the ass, too. This is your fuel pump. So basically, you have an option. You have pump to tank or pump to hose. Pump to tank would suck. Basically, if I hook that up, it would suck all the fuel out of my boat. So, like, if you have a tanker or something, because I think eventually you'll run out of fuel in that thing. I haven't yet, but I've only messed around with this for a few hours. So to get it so we can get fuel on our boat, you want to run out a bunch of cord, because you're going to have to make a jump with this. This is what I don't like about the game. You can't really, like, rope this. See how it's bouncing around like crazy? So we're going to run out some hose. We're going to switch it to pump to hose. So it's going to put the fuel into here. This is your up and down for coiling the hose back up, because it will get stuck into ship. And then connector release, these things are like magnets, basically. So let's pick this up and I'll show you. So we got to get fuel in here. I do have a fuel gauge. I don't remember where I put it, though. So jump. There we go. All right, so here it hit. So now it's there. And see, we're moving around a lot, but our fuel gauge is full. So now we have 187.50 on that. So now you definitely want to unhook this, because I tried to take off earlier with it, and it sucked. I got to build that a little taller. So it's like trial and error. I don't think there's a right way or wrong way. We'll reel that up later. Let's go for a ride. All right, so what I'm going to do here is we're going to get the motor started up. So we're going to give a little bit of RPMs to the engine. I hope you guys can hear it. Can you guys hear it running? So I'm going to run it really low there. So I got my gauge over here. So the battery's at 100%. Fuel's at 100%. I can manually turn this and drive it, but I also have it wired up through the chair. So if we actually hit forward or back on here, it would actually start to move. You get in your pilot's chair by hitting F. And then we're going to give her a little bit of forward momentum. Oop. Get us away from that. The waves are kind of pushing us. See, there's full, like,
people on waves and everything. I'm sorry if the sound's a little bit loud. I'll check it out after we record this video. So I think I have a button right there. Yeah, okay. Yeah. All right, we stopped. All right. Don't get out of the chair with the votes going at full speed. So we got smoke coming out the back. That's our exhaust. I have damage off because I don't want to deal with that right now. So that's the lights I installed. I just did it so we can kind of see a little bit. And there's some lights out the front. So our battery will charge up fairly good. So I think if we go full speed, see how we're losing on the battery. And I think I wired it wrong. So we have like 8 batteries. I think that's just reading one of the batteries. So I think that the other batteries still have plenty of charge in them. I've never actually ran until I hit zero, but you can go quite a ways. And this is a pretty fast boat. You hit tab to go into third person mode, and you kind of see how your boat can go underneath it. So our rudder is not perfect, but it's going to be enough. So we don't really steer in a dime. But say I got ladders coming up the side so we can get people back on it. So I just made like a little rescue skiff. I haven't tried it in high seas or anything like that, so I don't know how it's going to do. How are we doing on time here? I think we got 10 minutes. Let's see if we can do a quick mission. Because I'd like to see how this boat reacts and stuff, because I don't even know if I have it. Do I have a temperature gauge? So yeah, I don't know at what point the engine grenades itself. So I think we can actually still charge with a really low RPM. Oop, I think I'm going to stall it. Still idling. So we're charging back up, I think, aren't we? Oh yeah, slowly. All right, we'll worry about that in a minute. How are we doing on fuel? It does suck down the fuel. All right, so to get into a mission, I want to show you how big this map is. Okay, so we just came from here. This map is, I can't even drag it to the edge. That's the edge of the map. And it's just like 7 Days to Die or Minecraft. It's completely randomly generated by those numbers. So you'll see all kinds of stuff. One time I saw one of those water-based... Uh-oh. Hopefully it'll center us. Oh, it didn't center us back up. Oh, do we center? Oh, center. Oh, that's missions. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Crap. I think I screwed us over. I don't know where we're at now. No! Don't make me look an idiot right off the bat. Where's our islands? Yeah, we screwed up. Okay, let's find a mission. Alright, so... Store nuclear waste. 3 containers of nuclear waste require storage in the underground storage tank below this guy company nuclear. And it's completely random missions too. It's pretty sweet. Special engineers required are not available, but the waste has been removed from the reactor and is at the station awaiting disposal. Use the forklift or other means to move the waste from the upper level to the underground storage pool. Okay, it gives you an hour to do it. So we just tagged it. That means we're going to be able to do it. And of course it's nighttime. I have no idea which way we're going. We're going that way. It gives you a waypoint here. Now, as you're driving around, watch the water. That's like I like riding out here. Because if you... Oh, one of our lights is burned out in the back. I think I forgot to hook up a light. That sucks. It's kind of hard at night. I'm sorry if the video is really dark. That's about as light as I can make it. What was I going to say? I forgot already. Because you'll see crates floating in the water. You want to pick those up because those will give you... That's kind of like prizes. They give you more parts and sometimes cash, I think, maybe. Don't quote me on the cash part. I know that it does give you more parts. Because you have a limited supply of parts. As we were going across those parts, you could see, you know, 5 available, 10 available, 6 available. If you find blueprints, which are in those bins, you can build an unlimited amount of those parts. So it's just to make the game more challenging. And, of course, I still have the map screwed up. Oh, this sucks. I don't know where we're... Oh, okay, so there's that. So we got to be close to that, right? Are we going south or north or... Sorry about the mouse clicks. I'm trying to find where we are. Well, we'll be able to find ourselves when we make it there. So if you go into first person mode, you can get a reading on how far away it is. So we need to go to the little icon first, and then the circle with the flag on it, I believe, is where we go next. I've only done a handful of missions. I wish I had a speedo on here. I don't. Batteries are getting low. Let's give her some juice. Hopefully that'll charge us up. Running. Maybe a little bit less than that. You gotta experiment around with it. I haven't blown up a boat yet, but I haven't. This is as far as I've really got. I don't even know what our top speed is. I don't have a. That's one thing we don't have unlocked yet is a speedo, basically. So we're just kind of guessing, but I think we're clipping along pretty good. So you can add more propellers. It's like all up to you. That's what I like. I like the freedom of the game and the replay. I always judge a game on replayability, and I think that you'll never get sick of this because, like I said, I've seen everything. I've seen submarines. I've seen like people build these offshore rigs and stuff like that. Helicopters, blimps. I mean, planes. I've seen there's a couple YouTubers that are making all these World War II recreations. So the sky's the limit. I mean, it's if you like Kerbal Space Program, you like Space Engineers, you like games like Minecraft, then this is definitely one you want to pick up because the physics are pretty great. You get storms and stuff. When I was playing easy mode, I was coming back from a mission and the waves started picking up crazy, and that's I kind of found out my boat wasn't really as good as I thought it was, because as soon as it got really choppy, that the boat sank. So your boat will sink. If you have damage on, your boat will break apart, you know, so it's pretty awesome. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to stick around 30 minutes for our episodes here. This is obviously episode one. And I think what we're going to do is a lot of times if we have a long distance to go, we're almost there now. What we'll do is I'll fast forward through that so you don't have to sit and wait. Unless we got something cool that we're talking about or I'm drinking soda like now. So yeah, this is our first boat. We'll have to name it. I gotta finish painting it too. I see I missed a spot there and missed a spot right over there. So it's all up to your imagination. So I don't think I can bring up the store right now, but if you bring up the workshop, you gotta kind of watch though, because if you're playing like creative mode, I think it doesn't matter, but if you're playing in like easy mode and spawn up some of these bigger boats, those are all built like with this advanced system. So the advanced system basically disabled. Another problem I found, because I was just going to spawn us up a boat instead of building one. I was just going to pick somebody's nice small boat creation. Is they had parts that I don't have unlocked yet. So those parts just disappeared. Well, then the boat sank because there's holes in it. So it's just easier to do it this way. Right, I'm going to slow us down here because I want to bring up the map now that we're finally caught up with it. Oh, I was just zoomed out too far. All right, so where we came from, this is where you want to use the money for too, so we can buy more islands with bases on them. So we want that one there for 90,000. See, we're down to 90,000 already just for spawning this boat up. But when you build it, costs money. You have to keep an eye on where the diesel fuel locations are, especially since if you have, you know, limited fuel. There's a fuel location there. All right, so where is our dock? Is there a dock? You can zoom these maps right down. The motor's sitting there running away. At least it's charging the battery up. I don't know where we dock at. Is that a port right there, maybe? Let's go that way. So that's to our right. See, this is why you need reverse. You can't do anything without reverse in this game. And like I said, I just don't know how to do that yet. I'm not good enough at the game. I just started. V will turn on your own personal flashlight, because it is night a lot here. This may be. Can we pull in there? I need somewhere with a ladder. Oh, back it up. Oh. This is like where big boats get parked. Okay, there's a staircase at the end. Alright. Because I do know we did turn sharks on, didn't we? Alright, so we're here. Alright, so I'm going to stop us right about there, I think. Maybe a little bit far forward. Especially if you're playing with damage on, you will mess up your boat. Okay, sensitive. You can adjust all the sensitivity of your controls, too, and all that. And it's a lot of experimenting. So what we're going to do is we're going to kill this motor. And we're going to turn off the lights. My battery's not bad. All right, so let's get out of here and let's find out. Remember, what were you going to use, a high-low or something? Which is going to be interesting. Stay right there. Don't go anywhere. Usually you have to, like, haul stuff. This is pretty sweet. I bet you we have to use that elevator or something. I know nothing about this mission either. What are we doing? All right, everybody. We're running out of time. So in the next episode, we'll figure out what the hell we're doing here. And we're going to use a hilo, apparently, to load up our boat with nuclear waste. So we might have to do a redesign. And that's the nice thing, too, is make multiple saves of your boats for different things. Like right now, we have it set up for running people. But if we have to, I think we can run cargo on it, too. So we'll get back to that. And we'll see you guys in the next episode. I hope you enjoy the series. And we'll see you soon.